Hey everyone, this is Mara the Reading Hedgehog with my March 2017 book haul. So, I bought a lot of books this month, somewhere in the 30s range. I haven't actually counted because I kind of don't want to know. So we're just going to jump straight into this. And long story short of why I bought so many, I kind of went to Powell's City of Books and splurged. Yeah. But anyway. So the first books I'm going to show you are new releases. Now, some of these are new releases for February because I actually didn't buy them until March. So I will start by showing you February releases. So the first one I have to show you is The Valiant by Leslie Livingston. This is the first book in The Valiant. I believe it's going to be a duology. This came out February 14, and this is historical fiction about female gladiators, more specifically some women that were kidnapped from Britannia, and I believe this follows, our main character is actually a princess of ancient Britain, a Celt. And it follows them, and it is based off historical events, and I'm very excited about this book because I love stories set in Rome. There aren't enough of them, and there aren't many about female gladiators, obviously, but I'm also really nervous about this one because it could be really, really bad if they just, you know, fill it with girls with angst and chips on their shoulders, and it could go really wrong, but I'm hoping it'll be really good, and so I'm really looking forward to picking it up. Next up, I also bought Saturdays at Sea by Jessica Day George. This is the fifth and final book in her Castle Glower series. This came out February 21st, and this is a middle grade fantasy series that I've been keeping up with as she's been publishing them because I love Jessica Day George's books and I love middle grade, and this has been a really, really fun series, and I'm sad that this is the last one, but at the same time the series is reaching a very satisfying conclusion, and so it will be a really, really good ending to this series. Next up I have Long May She Reign by Rhiannon Thomas. This also came out February 21st, and this is actually the first book in a planned, I believe it's a trilogy or a duology, I'm not sure which, but there is going to be a sequel, which I did not know when I bought it. I don't think I knew that when I bought it. I don't remember. But in any case, unless I'm getting this confused with another book which has a sequel that I didn't know about, I'm pretty sure this one's going to have a sequel. Anyway, don't really remember what it's about, except that it has to do with a fantasy world and obviously a female ruler and probably a rebellion and probably reclaiming a throne. That's usually how they go. But it obviously sounded good enough when I read a synopsis to buy it. And so, yeah, looking forward to it. Especially since I can't remember what it's about. Next up, probably my most anticipated release of February, was A Conjuring of Light by V.E. Schwab. This is the conclusion to her Darker Shades trilogy, and this came out February 21st. And this is, for those of you who don't know, her adult high fantasy series, well, fantasy slash alternate reality slash alternate history. It crosses several of them. Technically adult, easily enjoyed by YA readers, obviously, and follows all these different parallel Londons and some characters to them. That's really all I'm going to tell you, other than it is an amazing series, her best by far. I mean, I love all of her books, straight down to the very first one she published, The Near Witch. Loved The Near Witch when it came out. But this definitely is her best. It's got an incredible world, incredible characters, incredible storyline, and I'm really sad it's ending, but I'm really looking forward to this, and it is thick. It's long, so it's not going to disappoint, I guarantee you. After that, I bought The Beast is an Animal by Petronelli von Arsdale. This came out February 28, and this is a standalone as far as I know, and it has to do with witches and soul eaters and a creepy thing called the beast that lives in the wood and probably devours people and something like that. but it sounded cool, and the cover is very creepy and gorgeous, and I'm looking forward to reading it, because, yes, I need some creepy reads. After that, I bought Frog Kisser by Garth Nix. This is also a February 28 release, and as you probably can guess, this is a retelling of The Princess and the Frog, which is a fairy tale not many people retell, but Garth Nix is a great writer, and really looking forward to his take on this, especially since I think it's going to be a more comical read. So yeah, looking forward to picking this up at some point, probably fairly soon. After that, I bought The Bone Witch by Rin Chupeco. This came out March 7th, so now we're into the March new releases. And this is the first of a planned series. I think it's a planned trilogy, but not sure how many there's planned. And this is about a necromancer. That's about all I remember, other than, you know, she's a girl. And her powers are probably forbidden. But I read Rin Chupeco's first book, The Girl in the Well, before it came out. I read an ARC and enjoyed it. It was really, really creepy. Wasn't the biggest fan of how the style in which she was written, so I'm really curious to read her latest book and see what the style is like. If she maybe, if that's her normal writing style, or she just adopted it for that particular story. So yeah, looking forward to seeing what this one's like. After that, I bought Hunted by Megan Spooner. This came out March 14, and this is a Beauty and the Beast retelling. Go figure, whoever. I mean, big surprise that Beauty and the Beast retellings are being released in March. So this is a Beauty and the Beast retelling where the Beauty is actually hunting the Beast, because the Beast terrorizes the woods that they live in. And of course, things probably are not as they seem, and yada yada. I am looking forward to reading this. I'm a little skeptical at the same time, because after Cruel Beauty by Rosamund Hodge, I'm not easily impressed by Beauty and the Beast retellings. I won't lie, she's kind of solidified the best retelling I've ever read. So yeah, I'm curious to see how this one's gonna go. After that, I picked up The End of Oz by Danielle Page. This is the fourth and final book in her Dorothy Must Die series, and this was also a March 14 release and probably my most anticipated release for March. For those of you who don't know, this is a series that follows another girl from Kansas who gets swept to Oz only to find out that Dorothy has gone evil along with all of her quote-unquote friends, and now the new girl from Oz, Amy, must kill Dorothy and all of her minions and save Oz and put things right. And this is the conclusion to that. I love this series so much. I hate Oz. I really hate Oz. I read all of the original books, which is, I think, about 15 of them in 1 year. You wouldn't think that would be so hard because they're pretty short. Oh, it was hard. It was really hard. I think I hit my wall at whatever number Rinkatink on Oz is. I hate Oz. But I adore this series because it takes all these little things and twists and makes them dark and creepy, and I just love it. So I can't wait to see how this one's gonna end. And because I hate Oz so much, I adore this title. I just love it so much. And of course, you know, since that one came out, she also released a third volume of the Dorothy Must Die stories. This also came out March 14th in tandem with the last book. And this is a collection of three more novellas. I don't know who these follow, actually. But the ones that are in here are The Order of the Wicked, Dark Side of the Rainbow, and The Queen of Oz. The first collection kind of told backstories of when Dorothy returned to Oz. Wizard's backstory and, Jellia's. And then the second one told the backstories of the Tin Woodman, the Cowardly Lion, and the Scarecrow told how they became what they are in the Dorothy Must Die series. So I'm not sure who these follow exactly. I haven't actually read the synopsis, so. But it's okay. I'm still really looking forward to seeing those because I've read the novella collections, and they, oh my gosh, they're good. They're creepy. They're really dark. So I'm looking forward to this one. Next, I bought Pyromaniac by Leech McBride. This is the sequel to Firebug, which is a companion duology to her Hold Me Closer Necromancer duology. This came out March 21st, and I will confess I have not actually read any of her books. I have them all now. Got all four of them. One of my friends, Rachel, has, I think, read most of Hold Me Closer Necromancer, but hasn't finished it quite yet, because she's bad about finishing books. But she is really liking what she's read, and I've really enjoyed Leech McBride's lectures when I've gone and met her at a couple of author events when she was part of multi-author panels. So I'm really looking forward to actually picking up all of her books. Now that I have them all, I can binge them, because that'll be fun. Next up, I have Nemesis by Brendan Reich, also a March 21st release, and I'm pretty sure that this is the first book in a planned duology, trilogy, series, what have you. Don't know too much about it other than it's a mystery, and there's weird things going on, and I know it follows a girl who gets murdered every night. On her birthday, every 2 years, on her birthday, she keeps getting repeatedly murdered. And then it follows a boy who keeps having nightmares about murder and weird things, and just kind of weird stuff is happening. And I know that James Dashner posted on Facebook about liking this, so yeah, it sounded weird enough that I was like, yeah, we'll give it a try. So I picked it up. So, whoops. Those are gonna fall. So those are all the new releases for what remained of February that I was not able to cover, and of March that I bought. There were other releases in March and February, obviously, but those are the ones I bought. So yeah, the next books I'm gonna show you are ones that I got on my Powell's run, and it's a mix of standalones that I've read, that I have not read, they're on my list, and but mostly of sequels to series that I own most of the series, but I don't own all of the series. So yeah, we're gonna actually start with the standalones first. I actually organized these guys. It's crazy. So out of the standalones I bought, I'm impressed that I actually took the time to organize these. I have Shirley by Charlotte Bronte. This is a classic. And yes, I've been collecting, I've been good in continuing collecting classics this year, because I got a lot of classics, but I can always get more classics. There's always more classics that I don't have, and I really want to finish buying all the Bronte sisters books, and Powell's had this one, so I got it. End of story. I need more room on the floor for all these books. Next up, I have Traitor Angels by Anne Blankman. And this is a standalone. This is written by the author who did A Conspiracy of Blood and Smoke, which is a historical fiction duology following Hitler's niece, which I have the first one, and I have not read it yet, but I've heard really good things about it. And since I've heard really good things about it, I picked up her standalone, which I did not know she had released another book. And this takes place during King Charles II's reign, after his exile, and actually follows, I believe, the daughter of the poet John Milton who wrote Paradise Lost. So it sounds pretty interesting. We shall see. Next up, I picked up Newt's Emerald by Garth Nix. I got a bit of a Garth Nix theme going on. Don't remember what it's about, but it's been on my list since it came out. I just never got around to buying it, even though I kept seeing it on shelves. I was like, oh, need to buy it, but it just wasn't on my priority list. Well, finally, I just went and bought it because, like I said, this was a splurge. It was a splurge. It's been a while since I've done this big of a haul. So yeah, I think it's a mystery involving a missing emerald, which I love those. I'm sure there's some magic. And it might take place in Victorian England, which would be amazing if it did, because I love mysteries set in Victorian England that have to do with missing gems. Don't ask why, I have no idea. I just love them. Next up, I have The Remarkable Journey of Prince Jin by Lloyd Alexander. I have read this book a long time ago. I've been collecting Lloyd Alexander's books whenever I can find them, and if I can find them in hardcover, you better believe I'm going to buy them. And this is kind of a typical, kind of fairy tale-esque, but you know, this character, he gets cursed and he goes on a journey, meets all these people, goes through crazy things, and just pure gold for people who still love adventure stories, and I love adventure stories, so yeah. Following in that vein, I also bought The Iron Ring by Lloyd Alexander, which is pretty much almost identical to The Remarkable Journey of Prince Jin, except it takes place in India, which I'm upset, or I was, I still am. I'm obsessed with Indian lore and culture and stuff. I have been since I was a kid. I blame it on my obsession with Francis Hodgson Burnett's books. I don't know why, but I always have been. So yeah, really love this book, and yes, I've read it. After that, I have The Shining Company by Rosemary Sutcliffe in hardcover. Do you have any idea how hard it is to find her books in hardcover over here? It's almost impossible. So whenever I find them, I snatch them up, and thankfully they're usually really cheap. Rosemary Sutcliffe wrote historical fiction. I should say she's no longer alive. It's awful. Her writing style is just gorgeous. No one else can compare. I mean, her writing is just beautiful. The Shining Company happens to be my sister's favorite. I remember really liking it. It's been a while since I've read it. And this has to do with pretty much a failed battle. Everyone gets massacred. Almost everyone. It's really tragic, and it's wonderful, and it's, of course, based off history, like the battle actually happened, and yes, I bought this. Because. Pull out my next one. So the next books I'm going to show you are sequels to series that I own, pretty much all of them except the ones I just bought. So the first one I have is Pip Bartlett's Guide to Unicorn Training by Jackson Pierce and Maggie Stiefvater, and this is actually a new release. I don't remember if it was February or March that it came out, though. You would have to double check on that. But this is the second book in their Pip Bartlett's series. It's a middle grade series. And I'm really, okay, a little bit of a rant here. I'm really disappointed that they changed the binding. Like, the original one has a dust jacket and really pretty. And this is just like, I don't know how to describe this binding, but I know you guys have seen it. Like, this, it's glossy and hard and no dust jacket. And I'm disappointed that they changed this. I'm really disappointed. But I'm sure the book will be good anyway. Next up, I've got two that are part of the same series, and that is Leviathan, Book 1, and Goliath, Book 3, in the Leviathan Trilogy by Scott Westerfeld. This is steampunk slash alternate history. I have Book 2, which is why I only got Book 1 and 3, and now I've got all three. Really like this series. It's weird, and the Fabricated Beasts still bother me. They're just creepy, but it's still a really good story, kind of an alternate reimagining of World War I with steampunk elements. Lots of steampunk elements. But it's really wonderful, and I'm glad I was able to buy the rest. Oh gosh, they are heavy. Next up I have City of Secrets by Mary Hoffman. This is book 4 in the Stravaganza series. Now this is an old series. Oldish. It seems like it's old. No one reads it anymore. Each book follows a different kid who kind of has something wrong with their life. They might be dying from an illness or whatever, and they will find this artifact that will take them to kind of an alternate reality Venice, but still medieval times and with magic. And these travelers are called Stravaganzas. And usually they go to the world because something major is happening in that world that they need to help fix, essentially. This series has its ups and downs. I remember really hating book 3. I don't remember why, but I did. But overall, it's a really good series, and I'm trying to collect all of them so I can have them on my shelf, because they're really hard to find now. And so, yes, I got book 4 now. So I think I'm only missing one more, and then I'll have the entire series. Next up, I have The Game of Lives by James Dashner. This is the third and final book in the Mortality Doctrine trilogy. I'm not going to say much about the series because I have issues with it, and I don't want to have issues with it because I feel really bad criticizing James Dashner's stuff, because he's a really nice guy, and I know it would make him sad if I did, so I don't want to, because it's wrong to. But I did buy the third one, so I can at least finish the trilogy, and you guys probably will not hear me say anything about this series because I'm not going to have anything nice to say about it. And I don't want to do that to poor James Dashner. I would feel bad. I would feel bad. I met the guy once when he was touring, and he's really, really nice, and I would feel bad. Especially since this series is so near and dear to his heart. So, yeah, enough said. We're not gonna touch that. No. Next up, I bought The Black Reckoning by John Stevens. This is the third book in the Books of Beginning. I don't know if this is a trilogy or if there's gonna be more. I have the first two. I've never read this series yet. I don't even really remember what they're about. I bought the first one because I found it for $1 in hardcover and it was signed. And it sounded interesting, but I couldn't tell you what they're about anymore. But Powell's had the third one, and I was like, hey, I might as well get it because I got the other two and I can splurge them. And hopefully I like this series. I haven't heard anything about it. Next up, I picked up Endure by Sarah B. Larson. This is the third and final book in her Defy trilogy, which is a guilty pleasures trilogy because it really isn't that good, but I adore it for some very inexplicable reason. Though I will say that with the second book, the series actually did get really good compared to the first one. So I'm hoping now that certain things were resolved in the second one that the third one will be really good and worthy of my love for it. But this is a this is fantasy, high fantasy, and actually takes place in a world that is very reminiscent of India or Thailand, both, kind of, which is really cool because it's not done very often in fantasy novels. And our protagonist, our female protagonist, is actually a really believable warrior. Like, I can believe she's actually good with the sword, which never happens given her attitude problems. But yeah, so I bought the third one so I can finish it, and it's pretty. It's shiny and pretty. It's gorgeous. Yes. Next, I bought Ungodly by Kendari Blake. This is the third and final book in her Goddess War trilogy. I told you I bought a lot of sequels. I have not actually read the second one, but I read the first one. Liked it pretty well. Had some issues with her rendition of Odysseus. So I went ahead and bought the third one so I could read the next two, and this is Greek mythology set in modern times, and the gods are dying for some reason that they don't really know why, and each god is dying in a very particular, gruesome manner, and I'm assuming it all eventually leads up to a war. And can I also complain? I love the cover of the first one. I do not like these new covers. They're reminiscent of a really bad, angsty teen TV show. I don't like these new covers. After that, I picked up Return of the Forgotten by Lisa Fiedler. I always mess up her last name. This is the third book in the Mouse Heart trilogy, which is a middle grade animal fiction trilogy, very reminiscent of Redwall, except it does take place in the human world. And it's got elements of dystopianism in it, and it's actually a really realistic dystopian society. Really been enjoying this series. It's a lot darker and more gruesome than one might expect. I'm not generally a huge fan of animal fiction stories, just animals with human characteristics disturbs me, mostly when they start behaving violently. It's just kind of, I don't know, it bothers me. But this is a really good series so far, and I look forward to seeing how it ends. After that, I bought The Darkest Magic by Morgan Rhodes. This is the second book in her Book of Spirits and Thieves trilogy, which takes place before her Fallen Kingdoms series, but follows a character that comes from our world and ends up in Mitka, if I remember correctly. I haven't read the first one yet, but I went ahead and got this one because Barnes & Noble's been carrying hardcover for a while, and I was like, you know, right around the time that I refinished the first one and I want the second, they're not going to have it anymore. So I went ahead and picked it up. I don't think it needs to be read in any particular order. I think you can read it whenever you want. As I haven't heard anything about when you need to read it, so yeah. Next is a pile of more sequels. These are actually the beginnings of series rather than, you know, somewhere in the middle of one, some are continuing. So the first one I have is Dragon Watch by Brandon Mull. This is the first book in his Fablehaven spin-off series, I believe. And I think this is a fairly new release. I'm not sure when it came out exactly. I didn't even know it was out until I was browsing Walmart, which I do on occasion. And it was there, and I was like, hey, I haven't read Fablehaven yet, but I might as well get it. So I did, and I have no idea what it's about. But even if you know anything about Fablehaven, I probably don't have to give a description, because it's along those lines. After that, I bought The Dale Mark Quartet by Diana Wynne Jones, and this is actually all four. I think there's four books in the series. That would be my guess, since it's called a quartet. But I don't know. Yeah, four. So this is all four books in a giant bind-up, and I have no idea what it's about. The only Diana Wynne Jones series I've read is Howl's Moving Castle. Shocker. So, yeah, I don't know any of her other works. But it sounded really interesting, and you don't find bind-ups like these very often. So I got it. And we'll read it eventually. Next up, the series I have is actually a complete one. They had all three of them in stock. Powell's did, so I went and got them. And they are book one, Princess Academy, book two, Palace of Stone, and book three, The Forgotten Sisters, all by Shannon Hale. And no, none of them match. They kept changing the book, the cover, and this is still my favorite cover. And this is a fairly old series, but kind of considered a classic. And it's not a retelling of any particular fairy tale, but it's got a very fairy tale-esque feeling. And it's one of those rare series where book one did not need a sequel. But the sequel was pretty good, and I haven't read this one yet, but I'm sure it's probably pretty good too. I've been meaning to buy this trilogy for quite a while, so I did, and yay, I got them all. After that, I picked up the beginning of a series, and that is, let's see here, book one, Revenge of the Witch, and book two, Curse of the Bane, which is the first two books in the Last Apprentice series by Joseph Delaney. I remember when this series came out. I did not read it when it first came out because someone I really, really, really did not like loved this series. And my policy back then was kind of like, if he likes it, it's probably crap. And I was usually right. So I did not read this series. But now that I'm well past that and I'm no longer in association with that person anymore and his illusion of certain things is dissipated, I've decided to pick up the series. Pals had them for cheap. This is middle grade. I don't remember what they're about, really, at all. But I bought the first two, so we can see. We'll see if I like them. And they weren't too expensive, so no biggie. After that, at the beginning, the first two books in the beginning of another series. This is a series that will be familiar to a lot of people, and it is Graceling. So I got book one, Graceling, and book two, Fire, by Kristen Cashmore. They did not have the third one in hardcover, at least they didn't have it with the original cover art. They redone the cover art, and I really don't like the new cover art. I actually have no idea what this is about, other than it's fantasy. But I do remember that there was a lot of hype surrounding it when it first came out, and I put on my list to read, but I never got around to it. But I went and got the first two, since they had them in hardcover, and looking forward to seeing what all the fuss was about. Now that the hype's died down too, I'm more interested. I don't really like it when books have a lot of hype, I just kind of lose interest. Finally, the last book I got is Timekeeper by Tara Sem. This is the first book in a planned series, I believe, and I don't know what it's about. Except that it takes place in an alternate Victorian world that's controlled by clock towers, where a damaged clock can fracture time, and a destroyed one can stop it completely. That sounded really, really cool. So this is either going to be an amazing book, or it's going to be awful. It always seems like these kind of stories, there's no in-between. They're either really good or such a massive disappointment that you just kind of never want to see it again. But I'm hoping it will be really good, because that concept is really cool. So, yeah, those are all the books I got in March. I got a couple of manga. They're floating around somewhere. I'm not going to go retrieve them. I got the volume 10 and 11 of the First Basket Collector's Editions, which were the releases for February, March, and then there's one more left coming out in April, and then I'll have them all, and then I can read the series. So I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I'm very sorry it was so long and rambly, but if you have any questions, comments, reading these books, or just want to say hi in general, feel free to comment down below, and I will see you guys around. Bye!